Clark's Classic Rock, Q104.3.
Good morning, and I am so pleased to introduce you to, I didn't know he was a listener, Jesse Eisenberg, who was Oscar nominated for The Social Network. He was in The Squid and the Whale. Loved you in Adventureland. I know, thanks. A lot of people didn't see it. Loved you in Zombieland. Can't wait for the sequel. There better be a sequel. Let me tell you something first about Zombieland, and then I'll introduce everybody else who is here in our studio. Not a day goes by when I go in a public restroom and I open the door of the stall when I'm not terrified of being greeted by a zombie. Thank you, Jesse Eisenberg from Zombieland.
I was like that before the movie.
Yeah.
And it was a comedy, but it was a horror comedy.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the sequel comes out in October.
Awesome.
It's like a 10-year anniversary.
All right, that's awesome. So the reason Jesse Eisenberg is here, he's not starring in a movie. He executive produced one of the best documentaries out this year. It actually is the only movie open this weekend that got 100% on Rotten Tomatoes. Mm-hmm. And the movie is called The World Before Your Feet. You can only see it right now at the Quad on West 13th Street. And it's basically the story, and we have with us Matt Green, who walked basically, well, he's still walking, but he is walking every inch of New York City. Not only every street, every cemetery, every beach, every bridge. It has taken up 6 years of his life. Also with us, the man who directed the documentary, Jeremy Workman. And you got to see this movie because it is an absolute love letter to New York. So first, Matt, why? Why would anyone want to do this?
I don't know
why. You quit
why.
Your job as an engineer.
I quit my job as an engineer. I had this longing to go out and see all these places that I just knew from the map. Wanted to see what they look like on the ground. And I was just very curious. And I don't have a better explanation than that. I just really felt the compulsion to do it.
But actually, Matt's walked across the country even prior to walking every single street in New York City.
Yes, that was in 2010. I did a walk across America.
So secretly, you just want to stay in shape.
Yeah, that's all it is.
That's all it is.
I want to be able to eat as many Cinnabons as possible.
All right, Jeremy, how did you get to do this project? Did you know Matt?
I did. I'd been friends with Matt for a long time before, and I don't think he'd have let anyone else sort of follow along with him if he wasn't friends with them, because I then spent 3 years making the documentary and following him.
Also to stay in shape.
Yep, that was the only reason.
Jeremy was carrying all this camera equipment, too. Keep that
better
in mind.
Shape.
Yeah, so I also got to work on my bicep.
And I would like just ditch him in the dust, and you know, he'd get his shots, and he'd have to run with all this equipment to catch up. So.
And Jesse Eisenberg, how do you come into the story? Were you friends with Jeremy, do you guys go way back?
No, we had met briefly, and then Jeremy filmed 500 hours of footage over the course of 3 years following Matt. So, you know, I think got to a place in his editing where he kind of lost his own perspective and just wanted a fresh pair of eyes to take a look at it. He thought I would like it. He was exactly right. I had never done anything like this, which is to say, you know, produce a movie that I'm not, you know, in. But he sent it to me, and I was flabbergasted. I just thought it was absolutely incredible in so many ways. The movie is like, you know, I'm a New Yorker and my college major was anthropology. So it's like it fit a couple of boxes for me, being curious about people and being interested in New York. But it went beyond that. It talks about like the psychology of Matt. You know, what is the compulsion to do this thing that he can't exactly explain? What do his ex-girlfriends say about his kind of myopic vision of doing this one particular goal exercise? And so the movie just hit so many wonderful things for me that I just wanted to be involved in any possible way and to champion it and to hopefully get other people to like it as much as I do.
So, Matt, one of your relationships broke up during this six-year walk.
Started during the six-year walk also.
That's right. That's why she was attracted to you.
Well, she found out. She reached out and, she's an awesome person. We're still really close, but, you know, the relationship kind of ran its course over me, you know, doing this insane thing.
But it was more than that. Like, she just wanted to go to a movie with you, and this is not something that
movies are terrible. Stay away from the theater.
You're saying this to Jesse Eisenberg.
And the day isn't.
Yeah, Matt has trouble. You know, it's hard to keep social relationships when you're doing this sort of crazy project.
But it goes deeper than that because Matt is homeless by choice. And explain this.
Yeah, I mean, don't feel bad for me. Like I, you know, I just made a calculation economically that to be able to do this thing with the amount of savings I had, I couldn't be paying rent because I'm, you know, I make a little bit of money through it, but not much. So, so I just figured if I could just couch surf with friends, cat sit, house sit, I could string together enough places to stay to sustain me.
Do you know enough people where you could do this or what?
Yeah, when I was still working as an engineer, I'd started this walking group in New York City. And I had very few friends in the city when I started that. And I just met all these people who would randomly show up to come on these like 20-mile walks in Staten Island. And I just, you know, over the years made this great network of friends, all of whom were interested in walking and exploring and who were sympathetic to what I was doing. And so, you know, they helped me out. They let me stay on their couch. And then I started realizing, and they started realizing, oh, you know, I have this cat. It's a pain in the butt to find someone to watch him when I go out of town for 2 weeks. So I'll just get Matt to come over. So it kind of worked itself out that way.
I am speaking with the people behind and in the gem of a documentary you can now see at the Quad on West 13th Street. It's called The World Before Your Feet. Matt Green has spent 6 years of his life walking every inch of New York City, every cemetery, every beach, every bridge. Jeremy Workman directed the movie, and Jesse Eisenberg, yes, that Jesse Eisenberg from The Social Network, executive producer. Jesse, I wanted to ask you something that I read, and you never know if it's true, especially when you see it on IMDb and Wikipedia. Is it true that you have no Facebook page, even though you've starred in the Facebook movie?
Yes, and aren't you envious now?
Jesse just really loves irony.
I appreciate the irony. Yeah, I mean, I was like 10 years ahead of the curve of people deleting their Facebook pages. Well, I never had one to begin with, so I was 11 years ahead of the curve.
Do you have any social media presence?
When Jesse came on board to be involved in this movie, one of the first things he said to me was like, yeah, the movie's great, I'd love to be involved, but I'm not on social media. I don't do Instagram, I don't do Twitter,
nothing?
I don't do any of that.
No. I barely have social presence rather than social media presence. No, my life is so much more public than I would hope it would be in the first place. So I don't have any need to, you know, also tell people what I'm eating, you know, I mean, because I'm already mortified that I'm talking so much at, you know, multiple people at once.
But you have the publicist. I mean, I get the pressure, which is just ridiculous.
Right.
You know, you got to put it on Instagram. You got to tweet it. You got to do the Facebook. You have to have the pressure from your publicist, right, and your agent.
No, they gave up a long time ago. But I have like my sister who only listens to Q104.3, by the way. Hallie, if you're listening, which you are, hello. She is...
Thank you, Hallie.
She's the only one who pressures me, but that's because she's like 25, and for her, that's the only way she communicates, you know. So she tells me all the time. But I know the thing is, like once a year, I have to make some kind of like small public apology for something horrible I said accidentally. You know what I mean? And if I had Twitter, it would be like a daily thing. And I don't have the energy to constantly apologize.
I think secretly Jesse would like just to be walking every street in New York City.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. I mean, when I watched this movie, the first thing I thought of is, you know, I wish I could do that. You know, when I first really moved, because I grew up in New Jersey, when I first moved to New York City, I started doing some like urban exploration. There was like the abandoned train tunnels on 122nd Street. We like snuck into that and we went on the High Line before it was open as a High Line. And when I saw this movie, I realized like Matt kind of is doing the thing that I think a lot of people probably wish they could do when they first come to New York City, when their curiosity is still fresh. And then, of course, you get a job and you have your small circle of friends and you end up going to the same place every day, you know, for the rest of your life. And I think what Matt does, and I think why people like the movie so much, is it kind of gives them permission to go back to that time when they were still curious about the city that has so many interesting things that we end up not exploring.
We are out of time, but I just encourage you to watch this documentary. Go to the Quad on West 13th Street, The World Before Your Feet. It's just a love letter to New York. It's a gem of a movie. And as I told Jesse Eisenberg on our morning show with Jim Kerr, you got to do the narrative movie and you got to star. And I mean, this is you. This is your role. You got to do it. If you missed any part of this interview, you can catch up with it on my podcast, Sunstein Sessions. Just download the iHeartRadio app. And I wanted to let you know, coming up next, you know, we're all spending this holiday weekend with loved ones. And I'm going to introduce you to Maggie O'Hanlon, a new friend of mine who cannot do that because she lost her FDNY husband to September 11th toxins a little over a year ago, and she will pay tribute to her wonderful husband next. Q104.3.